Ashanda.
The mind of Christ, superior belief systems.
Every gathering against your life, today they scatter. If you don't know your purpose, don't get a partner. Don't get a partner if you don't know your purpose. You must know your purpose for life before. It's very important. Amen. I said amen. Life's purpose. You must know your life purpose. You must know your life purpose. By the wisdom and the knowledge of God, by God's grace upon your life, by prayer, by encounter, you must have discovered purpose. And you must have been cooked with the knowledge of that purpose. You know, Reverend John, do you know the word ignorance is not a statement, it's an accusation. Ignorance. So you are ignorant, meaning you have chosen to ignore knowledge. That's why you get the word ignorance. You ignored what you should know. That's why I say my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. And that scripture says because they are ignorant. What you are supposed to know, you ignored it. That's why it's called ignorance. There is something you ignored that you should have known. So because you ignored it, you have a problem. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So there are things. Before I got married, I did all my best. I tried to do, learn a lot. You know, there are foundational things that you meet in your family. There are people that say, oh, if you're from a family where your father beat your mother, you have to be careful or else you beat your wife. It's a choice. I never saw my father and my mother romantic, nothing. My father was a soldier, my mother was a policewoman. And my mother was not just a policewoman, she was a top policewoman. The kind of policewoman that was coming, the siren, people are jumping down from the car. So for that kind of woman to be stay at home money tonight cooking for a man, we had house help. So I never saw them in that lovey-dovey like my wife and I, you know. But I had to make up my mind on the kind of life I want. I never saw that. My mother buy my father a gift. Let me think. No. I never saw that. See, my father buy me a gift. No. My father comes back from work, he put curved glass, he's reading newspaper. My father will read every newspaper, even read the cartoon in the newspaper. She will read, he will read everything. My mom is busy. So I never saw that. I never saw anything like romance. It was not a chaotic home, but there was no, you know, lovey-dovey kind of home. You know, it wasn't there. And I knew that I had to make up my mind on the kind of home that I want. I'm not going to stop saying it runs in the family. You can break from it. You can choose to be different. You can choose to say you're not going to lift up your hand on your partner. And I've said this before. Any guy that lifts up his hand on a girl, if that girl is still remaining in that relationship, she's crazy. She's crazy. You don't. Out there, he has not paid anything on you. He's lifting his hand. Somebody has not seen your parents and is already beating you up. And you are still there. You say, it was just a fleet of anger. It's all right. We are here. You will come and tell us at the end of the day. So you have to discover life purpose, know your purpose for life before. All of these things must be in place before you think of entering into a relationship. You don't just rush into it. You don't rush in. You see, rush is risky in a long-term relationship. Rush is risky in a long-term relationship. Praise the Lord. Before you now talk about partnership, before you now talk about having a partner and all of that, how somebody who is going to be that person, you know, let me show you something. Are you sure you want to hear some of these things? Okay, let me leave that side. Amen. I say amen. Amen. There are, you see, as a lady, kill that mentality, kill it. That time is going. Men are scarce. Kill it. Kill it. It doesn't matter if it's happening to everybody around you. Kill it. Because if you think like that and you believe like that, you start attracting that life. kill it, just kill it. Perish that idea. Perish. Perish that idea. Perish that idea as a woman that you must spend more time on your looks than on your character. Perish. It's better to be a prey queen than a slay queen. It's better to be a prey queen than a slay queen. Perish that idea. Because have you noticed that most entertainers and superstars can't keep a home? Do you dress more than them? Do you know how many times they've changed their skin? If that's what it takes to keep a home, then trust me, most celebrities will have the best of homes.